The Wadden Sea is the largest tidal area in the world and is therefore a World Heritage Site. The seal is its top predator, and they seem to do well. Everything looks nice and healthy. But if you look more closely, this grey seal had netting around his neck, and they are threatened by more external factors. Therefore, Seal Centre Peter Buren is doing research on the threats for our largest predator. Every seal brought to Peter Buren is being examined.
I'm going to take blood from the seal. It's something we do with every animal. It's part of the veterinary checkup at arrival to know how is the status of the seal. So I feel the hips of the animal to know where I want to go in the intervertebral sinus. I disinfect with alcohol, and then I go with the needle.
Checks and double checks on viruses.
So now I'm going to take some swabs to detect viruses, and we do it from every the animals that arrive to know, yeah, if they arrive already with the virus or not, so we can monitor the population. We always listen to the lungs of every animal. It's part of the whole procedure.
In the last decades, we have seen a couple of outbreaks of virus infections in seals in the Wadden Sea area, killed about 50% of the total population. What we have seen happening with the seal population, it's that it got fragmented. So the virus can then not sustain itself. So that means if the virus comes in from somewhere else, from another population of seals, and we know or we think that the harp seal up in the north is harboring this virus, this is a huge population. And from time to time, these animals get into contact with our harbor seals and the virus spills over. And that's the way how the virus gets reintroduced. We're really worried for the future, of course, to be prepared if we see a similar thing happening again. So what we tend to do here in Peterborough is taking blood samples from the animals and check also for the older animals if they have antibodies against the virus. We try to get as much information as possible about infections, about pollution, about the functioning of their immune system. So there's a whole lot of things here that we can study here as a result of this rehabilitation setting.
Rehabilitation thus gives the scientists a great opportunity to look into the population and to assess the health of the sea. The samples are being brought to the University of Veterinary Medicine in Hanover, Germany. A couple of days later, a dead seal is being transported from Peter Buren to the Institute of Pathology to be examined by pathologists, not knowing what caused its death.
We know that these animals, especially when they're infected with certain viruses, like a distemper virus, the animals become immunocompromised, and that means that the immune system doesn't work well, and that means that all kinds of bacteria, but also other viruses, may get a chance. So the chance of people to become infected then, if they touch the animals, get bitten, because that's what a normal reaction. You see a sick animal, you touch it, and then the risk becomes, if there's so many sick and dead seals, there's a real risk there that people become infected. The first thing we check if this is not dangerous for humans. Fortunately, in most of the cases, it's not so. But for instance, with influenza virus infection, we have seen outbreaks in seals that were followed by quite a number of people becoming infected in the past. We should be aware that these, when I'm talking viruses now, that these viruses might transmit to humans as well.
This is measuring a wound that has the animal arrived with a wound in the belly area. With the seal, we just want to know if there is why this animal was not able to survive in the wild. We don't have any specific suspicion, so yeah, I'm very curious to see what he finds. When the animal was admitted, we felt some air bubbles underneath the skin, and now we can see some air bubbles out of where the air should be. The air should not be there. It is called emphysema, and that means that the air went out of the lungs.
with emphysema, so here we have the alveolar edema coming from cut surface. Yes, and here you have the rib imprints, so it shows that the lung is enlarged. Could be edema, but could also be edema as a consequence of inflammation.
When an autopsy on a seal is being done, do not just look at viruses, but we look at all the different infectious diseases. So we do it on the one hand for the seals themselves, for the population, to also for understanding more how the ecosystem works, and at the end of the day, also for safety of humans.
From seals to humans, we saw the same with the Q fever and the avian influenza in the past.
You cannot predict an outbreak, that's very difficult. We risk that within a couple of years we get a similar outbreak, and that means that about 50% of the animals might die, and we have to prepare for that. Yeah, because once you have so many seals on the coast, yeah, so dead animals, yeah, washing up, you have to have a scenario, you have to do what to do with these animals, how to handle that, how to instruct the people locally, and also what to tell the public at large.